First Corinthians chapter number 16, back to the verses that God will read in just a moment. And I'm just going to have a little bit of Henderson. I hope it will go off.
Amen.
And the bad thing, but those things come every day. Just keep me up to that. But I appreciate the Lord. I appreciate the privilege to do that.
Amen.
Yeah.
this country the last 40 or so years I've been preaching on missions. What kind of God would it be that would set up a church and not set up a method of financing? That would be like one of your men hiring 10 year olds and tell them to run the business, start a business, and hire 10 year olds and tell them I'll be back in 10 years. Why don't you pay the bill? Or you boys can figure it out. God's not that type of God.
Amen.
God would not give a great commission without giving the method of the Bible. God would not set up a church without setting up a plan of financial. What we must do is learn God's plan, learn to do it God's way, let God do it His way. And it's amazing what God does, as Brother Henderson brought illustrated. When you learn to give, God's method of giving to mission. Now, there's a lot of our thinking, and I prove myself, that needs to be changed. I had to go through some things on this. I'll just share a couple with you, and then I'll get right in the little bit. I'm going to preach and get out of the way. My wife and I have three children. They're of course grown and grandkids are grown now. But when our oldest two children were teenagers, we lived in the country. They had a road about half, I don't know, maybe a mile. There's what we call the country store. My wife would come to me and she said, I need a gallon of milk. Start saying a gallon of age. I need enough of that. She said, well, the kids down the store get me some milk. Y'all understand that language?
Right.
Try to call Donna, call David. I said, well, I want you to run down the store and get them from here. That's right. Say that, run down there and get it. But there's always one action that preceded that, coincided with it.
Amen. Right. Amen.
If I'm not going to order the milk,
amen,
I'm supposed to pay for it.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, sir.
So why don't God pay for it?
Amen.
I don't understand and say, well, we got to help the world God out.
No.
Well, we got to give all we can to help the world God out. No, God, when you're
wrong.
Amen. I want you to watch for a minute. There's a God in heaven. Can I get an amen?
Amen. 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 Amen.
He said, "Why do you believe that?" He said, "The rest of me scared y'all's gonna call them." God wants the world to hear the gospel. We don't have to beg God permission, brother. We don't have to beg God. God sent his son to die for the extreme soul purpose of saving sinners, and they cannot be saved unless we get the gospel to them. Now we'll just do this real quick. I've got too much here to say. God set a tithe to finance the local church.
Right.
The tithe is the first 10% of income. It does not belong to us. It belongs to God.
Right.
Now, I know there are those arguments, those critics, those who say, "Don't you know tithe is under the law?" You know, when somebody tells you that, you know what they're really doing? Revealing their ignorance.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The Bible's very plain. Abraham tithed at least 500 years before the law was given. Jacob said he wouldn't know what the Bible did, but anyway, at least he knew he was supposed to tithe.
Amen.
Then those who said, "Well, it's my money, I'm under the law to it." I'm smiling on this. I'm just kind of getting tickled what I'm thinking right here. I don't want him. Or you want him. Can you imagine that he spoke in the judgment seat of Christ? And the horse done said the tithe is the Lord's.
Amen.
They're saying it's theirs. My money, I do it. I just want to be right here so the judges in Christ say who wins that argument.
Amen.
You know who gets the argument. They're not an argument there. They just believe that.
Amen.
Then the Bible teaches us that we're to separate the tithe, his portion from our portion, bring it to church, dedicate it to God, and that tithe is to finance the normal operation of the church.
Right.
And I use the word we understand. That's to pay the bill.
Amen.
Pay the bill. That's God will take care of the man of God and others who may be on the staff or pursue me here. Just pay him the bill. Try to set up an ordained in the Bible, the tithe. Go where the Bible was in the tithe that was communal. It was used on the local city across the world right there.
Amen.
Now, but I'm getting one of them. The Bible teaches free will offerings.
Right.
Free will offerings, the Bible said, for special needs that arises in the life and ministry of the church. And by the way, if you've ever been around the Baptist church, you don't stay there long until they're taking them off.
Right.
It's just common. It's just common. It's breathing.
Right.
God's people want to give. That's a blessing. More blessing to give than receive. I know most Baptists are happy with a lesser blessing. They'd rather receive than give. I'm just saying that God will meet the need for which people. Now, but then there's a reason why I'm saying this. You see, God said if we're tired, he don't want to have one to listen to.
Amen.
I'm a candidate for that kind of message.
Yes.
I love your black folks preach. I'm a colored preacher. I'm blue. I love your black folks. It has never been job. I wish I could do it. I wish I could preach on Sundays. The black preacher preached one day on time, and he said to him, he said, "No, God said if you're tired, that means your house." Some of you don't believe that, do you? He said, "There's a man in the Bible, his mama named him Abram. One day he started tithing and God tacked a hand on his name." You can't be black to God. Amen. But God said, "I'm not going to let you outgive me in tithing."
Amen.
Then God said, "I'm not going to let you outgive me in free will offerings." Brother Henderson quoted it, use it, good measure, it's piled on, pressed down, shake it, and run it over. God, even your, tell me if you're going to lose it. God will not let you out. Let me just say this. Well, my faith always come in with God. You remember, I use the word investment. Now, I don't put you in the word give as a Bible word. I don't change the Bible. I put investment on that card for this reason. If I give you $100 bill, preacher, it's gone. I just cross the kitchen without it.
That's right.
Thank you, Kevin. Amen. But if I invest it,
right. There's
going to be return.
Yes, sir.
An investment is a Bible principle.
Yeah. That's right. Sure is.
Not losing what they give, it's an investment.
Amen.
Now, what's this one thing? I got to give you one thing. Tithe is 10% across the board. For all construction, You may put in a dollar, five, 10, 20, 50, 100. Usually the size of the need, how much you love that need, and how much you can give, all factor into it. Time is fixed for Lord Fletcher. But the mission given is begun by faith.
Yeah.
And faith is not me telling God what I can do.
That's good.
Faith is me telling God what He wants me to do.
Yeah.
It's no more than that. Yes.
Right.
I don't mean to be disrespectful, no truth. Just an obedient, trusting response.
Sure.
Amen. To the Word of God.
Yes.
So our giving to missions is to be done by faith.
Right.
Amen.
What is faith again? An obedient response.
Amen.
What God wants to do our day.
Yes.
We don't put God, we don't put times on, we don't put missions on percentage. You know why we don't? Watch me just, I don't die on me. I'm just. I don't put God on this matter of 10% of my income to mission. I'm talking about time and mission. So you know what I'm saying? God, if you give me $500, I'll give you commission. But if you will give me $1,000, I didn't give you $100, I'm gonna give you the other 900 instead. Faith promise giving is God, you give me 50, and I put all 50 missions.
Yeah.
You give me the 500, I put the whole 500 in there. Give me $1,000, I put the whole
1,000.
See, faith unlocks and looses God's ability to do what God wants to do in every individual life. Now look at the text. Now concerning the confession for the saints. Again, I remind you, this is not tithing. Tithes are not collected for saints. They're collected from saints. I've been in church all my life. I have never experienced somebody get up and say, well, six, seven more tithes and offer for a certain thing. Tithes are collected for the church.
Yeah.
Now, I'm talking about the needs of the church, not the church. He says, I give an order. The word order here doesn't have an S on it, and it's not orders. It's order. The word order without the S means an established time. So, if I give an order to the church of Galatia, now look at the last lifestyle, verse number one. Even so, you know what Paul is saying? Paul is saying, I travel across the province of Galatia. You might call it a state. And he said, in that state of Galatia, I started some churches. And in those churches, I established, and I use another word, I established a principle, a pattern, a method, a means, an order of giving. I mean, the name of serving God in a place, and I want you to agree. You know what's wrong with that? What is it still? I don't have in my hand the word of God without the word of God.
Yeah,
right. I don't have a Bible just written according to believers 2,000 years ago. I got one written to the Lord of my hand. Faith Baptist way back in 2016.
Amen.
So the Lord of God said, in those first 10,000 churches, I established this order, this principle, this pattern, this method, this meaning. Giving money, the name of the church of God is not a user establishment in your church.
Amen.
I could preach that anywhere in the world. I had the wonderful privilege of preaching that in London the churches.
Never
when I preached over the Washington. Somebody said, preacher, when I died, they're going to preach on King Max of Abraham. I said, just get the rest of the verse. Everything you live in. Abraham goes, I'll be all right. God's order is give up your sin in these words. Look at the verse number two. What is God's order again? Look at me just a moment. I want to say this now. One of the things that I battle for these years, I don't want you to be missions, but faith comes to you in a time of emotions. High emotions. I don't want you to give it a time of excitement. You say, preacher, why? When emotions are down, give them to be down. When excitement dies, give it down. But if you will give that knowledge, you shall know the truth. Happy real 10 months down the road as it is 10 minutes. What is God's order? Number one, what's your Bible? About the first day of the week. That teaches systematic I know the Baptists appreciate what I think you're going to get when you feel like it.
Amen.
So what's wrong with that? You don't feel like it. But here's how would you like to be down in New Mexico about 40 years ago waiting on Baptists to feel like sin in you? And don't die when I say that God's not a feel like it, God's a God of order.
Amen.
See, don't start with money. Boy, these are bad words to say that, but God's trying to teach us to be faithful.
Amen.
Depend on God.
Amen.
Don't crucify Him. Trust for Him.
That's right.
It's not just money, it's developing your Christian.
Amen.
Obedient to God. She's not even working. Then number two, God said in verse number two, that they warn you. I believe that includes you. I wonder who that excludes. And the reason I say that, I know a lot of Baptists that don't think they're supposed to hear. It's amazing how many Baptist churches, because of ignorance, just think they can give the mission that they want to. If they don't want to, it doesn't matter.
No. That's right.
It's not true. God said, I want every member of the church involved in my
mission.
And by the way, there is nobody who cannot participate because we're going to do it by faith anyway. And it's not what you can do, it's letting God do it through.
Yeah.
Right.
Amen.
And women. Number three, he said, according how much? According as God's cross. Your system and a given to a month, according as God's heart. If Baptists would give to missions as God has prospered us, as our brother just so well laid it out, we could finance a worldwide mission program, as we use the Georgia expression, in no time at all. Well, I know we're professional coal miners. We went to that college and told nothing to worry about, didn't we?
Yeah.
I was reading the Bible the other day and said, when you pray on the cross, my soul, if your cross is like mine, you better pray when you open the door. Set the ball down and break your foot.
Amen.
God tells us it's to be systematically told according as God's prospered us. And then he tells us in verse 4 and 5, 3 and 4 rather, it's to be a local church. Look at it just a moment.
I'll read the
verse. Missions is church business.
Amen.
This Bible is a local church.
Amen.
God is a local church. God, look at your Bible. In verse number 3, Paul said, when I come, whomsoever ye. Who is that ye? I know you know this, but let me say it to you again. In the translation of the King James Bible, they use the word. If it's plural, they use the wide word. Ye, you, you. If it's singular, they use the T word. They, thine. Now, let me show you something in the Bible. Look at this. This is a good argument against the Calvinist mother. Jesus said to Nicodemus, marvel not that I said unto thee, one person.
Right.
Ye, everybody, must be born again. The ye here is a plural pronoun that speaks of a collection of people, and the people that is addressed to is the local church.
Good.
All they say, if your mission is given to be systematic, given to the Bible, according to God's prospered you, given to the local church, and distributed by the authority of that local church. I will just say this 9-1. Tithe feast. This night, for your offerings, not surely. Size of the need, how much you love it, how much you can give. But mission is going to be done with faith. Now, I want to say this, and I'm not contradicting, there's no argument or abuse involved. Brother Henderson, a young Christian, heard of him.
Amen.
Brother Henderson, you would agree with it had to be God putting on your heart to start with it.
Amen.
I usually make this statement, ask God what I want to do. Sometimes you don't have to ask him, he just tells you. I was saved at the age of 9, called to preach at the age of 18, and at 32 I was introduced to Make Promise Missions.
Amen.
Three greatest things that ever happened to me.
Amen.
As a child of God.
Amen.
Give it, you cannot give God. You came out to come.
That's right.
Can I make this one statement? You came out driving either.
Amen.
Since God did not give you, God can do more.
That's right.
So just pray, thank God.